Hey everyone, Jack's on, Jack's off here today, and if you didn't know, we're doing a vlog. I'm doing it with Dark Home 7 and Pringle Sun. We are going to the Rausch Collection in Livonia, Michigan. It's a car museum that's also Jack Rausch's personal car collection. So don't expect any Chevys. It's pretty much just going to be all Fords, maybe some Mercurys, but but that's it. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Guys, Mark Martin's wearing a mask. Drag racers.
We're in the museum,
folks. Wasn't expecting that.
This is Mark Martin. Welcome, race fans. Please wear your mask. Before we start, I am going to have to pee, but take a look at all this stuff.
Hey, look, over there. It's Carl.
Oh, yeah, it says Carl.
I think it's his first win.
That looks like it, because it was the Scott's car.
The Scott's car, yeah. That's pretty cool.
And if my voice sounds a little bit muffled, it is because we do have to wear masks inside the museum, so I'm wearing masks. And we're gonna head in.
That's a Kurt Busch. Kurt Busch hood, right there.
Kurt Busch hood, according to the accent. He's gonna direct me a lot because I don't know a lot of this, so you're gonna be my guide today.
Okay, cool. I've never seen that before. That's insane. We got a hydrogen powered drag racer right here. It's pretty insane. Where should we start?
No, even when I'm not carrying a cart, I'll just make
NBC TNT cars from the good old days.
It's a replica though.
Yeah.
1/4. That's the biggest diecast I think I've ever seen.
Wow, those are cool.
Back when they played Fuel by Metallica.
Pepsi. That's crazy.
We're surrounded by cars and we just say Crystal Pepsi.
And then over there, there's some guys. Look, dual filming action.
Yeah, baby.
You're filming vertically.
Yeah, it's okay.
Oh god, that's disgusting.
That's a John Paul
Everybody
special.
Loves it. Everybody loves
John
this racing
Player's
nut.
Special.
Everybody loves this racing nut.
Oh my god.
There's Eli, by the way. He's not filming, but he's a bench.
It's a, I don't know who that is.
Okay, after the car, right?
I think
yeah, that
this,
was an experience.
I think this is Wally Dawn back.
I don't see a driver's name on it.
This car's in Forza. I know that. And, this Cougar, and I think it was said it was driven by Wally Dawnback.
Cougar.
The planters, it's on every car.
So this is just looks like a drag racer.
Right.
Thunderbird. I think it's just like a pro stock.
So driven by Holly
Hedrick.
Hedrick.
I think that's how you pronounce it. Sorry.
Land Speed Authority.
And over here's this green car. This is definitely a drag race car.
This is a hydrogen car. So this is like more like a land speed car.
Yeah, this is definitely drag racing, now I can tell.
Yeah, Tyler, the new shoes.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
EV station.
That's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, that is really cool.
And this is like, I didn't know Exide batteries made cars. That's pretty interesting.
Oh wait, I've seen this car before.
Really?
Yeah, I actually remember I saw an actual video of it being operated, and it's actually sweet. There's a car collector, and he has a ton of them. He actually has one of these, and he'll actually take it out and drive it.
Huh.
This is an old car.
And it's still road legal.
This is also an old
This
car.
Looks like an SUV.
It's a military
car. It's a military car, so it's got increased ground clearance and probably four-wheel drive, but it's like a modern SUV, I guess you would call it.
Nice.
Here's a motorcycle. I don't care. There's more over here. It looks... So we got a Mustang right here. Jack Rausch and Billy Johnson. And then we got... This is... A John Player Special Mustang.
John Player Special?
It's cigarettes.
Oh. What were these races?
Trans Am. And here's a Planters. Planters is huge in Trans Am. Oh, yeah. Look at this.
Well, I don't.
So, all of, I think you recognize all of these guys. Robbie Gordon.
I know Robbie Gordon. Who's Robbie Gordon?
He was Tony Stewart's teammate in IndyCar.
Tommy Kendall.
He raced in NASCAR a little bit. Oh, it's a Mercure. This is a Mercure. Mercure was a very, very infamous flop brand.
You know what I didn't notice? Is that we had to call and make a reservation, and they didn't even ask our names or anything.
Yeah.
They just knew that we were gonna
It's Scott Pruitt.
Yeah, this is a nice one, too.
This is Bobby Rahal.
I like the gold plates on the inline. This
is Bobby Rahal.
Oh, cool.
And Jeff Brabham, looks like. Here's some more. This is a Mustang Probe. That was one of the... Nobody's Fool Ford Mustang, driven by Mark Martin.
Yeah, Mark Martin.
Tommy Kendall. Paul Newman.
Paul Newman.
Paul Newman was awesome.
I just read the little thing on the Ellison traffic light there, and that's actually... That seems like a really good thing that should be implemented, like, fast.
Looks, this one, the Rolex 24.
Oh, nice.
And Nobody's Fool is a movie with Paul Newman, so if he didn't know that.
25-year anniversary one over here.
Of the Mustang. Tommy Kendall.
Oh my god, look what's over there.
We'll get to that later. There's a lot of winning cars.
I know. Okay.
We'll get to that later.
We gotta get these first.
This is a Tommy Kendall All Sport car. Whenever I see All Sport, I think of Jeremy Mayfield. I'm sorry. What surprised me is Mayfield and Everham have made up.
This is our Folds of Honor car.
That's kind of cool.
That's going on.
Let's look at these two. This is like a Roadster. This looks like a really old Indy car. Yeah, it is. It is an Indy car.
What it does is it allows you to see if there's like emergency vehicles approaching, like from which direction, but it also has a standard stoplight on it.
Huh. Cool. Okay, this is like just a Roadster.
Easily retrofitted.
Okay, we're getting into the what you've all been waiting for.
Now, this is a Carl Edwards.
This is Carl Edwards' Lumber Liquidators Red Sox car.
From when they won the World Series in 2007.
No, the reason they did it is because it was the first year Fenway, the owners of the Red Sox.
They won the World Series this year.
They did? Okay. Yeah. This was Ralph.
I touched the car.
Idiot.
Wow, look at it.
Tyler touched the car.
I touched the car, okay.
Okay, this was the last Roush win for a very long time.
For Biffle win at Michigan.
Michigan in 2013. This was the 3M ADA car.
Fun fact, they had this one down on display in 2018 at the August race in MIS down there.
This was a pretty crazy win.
This is Matt Kenseth's Talladega win in 2012.
The pink Ford EcoBoost car.
Holy crap, back when they did like the breast cancer awareness paint schemes.
They still kind of do.
Kind of, but not as much. All the Roush cars used to do that.
This is a Matt Kenseth car. Here's another Matt Kenseth car. This is DeWalt car. This is the championship car.
Is it?
03?
The 03 championship car. Holy crap. This is the 500 winner.
This is the 500 winner.
From 2009.
And there's Jack Roush's signature.
Oh my god, signed? Holy crap.
The whole crew signed it.
Holy moly.
I'm trying to find Kenseth and Drew Buchenstorfer.
Page the crew signed it, I don't know.
Holy crap, championship car. It's pretty crazy.
Please.
And here's one of the best finishes ever.
You have to read that.
This was an awesome finish.
Zoom in on it, because the viewers need to read it.
Key card's original state from the winner's circle, do not touch or remove the confetti. This is from the 2000.
Oh, wow, so this confetti is all in the same spot that
it's from the 2007 Pepsi 400.
Jamie McMurray. Barely be Kyle Busch. It was
the
awesome.
Last cup race with the Gen 4 car at Daytona.
Yeah.
And on the plate tracks in general.
And here's this is an Xfinity car. It's a City Financial car.
Look,
it's Xfinity now.
It's Matt Kenseth, I believe, right?
I think it's Biffle.
I don't know, Kenseth drove the 16.
So did Biffle.
Yeah,
I think this is 08 or 09. I don't know. Over here's a Mark Martin Winn-Dixie car.
this isn't the one that he took the pit road in the pistol race.
No, I don't think they'd have
this
that
from
here.
2000.
No, it's not. 97. Yes, that's 2000. You can tell. Oh. Because this is a Thunderbird.
I was about to say, it doesn't look like it's from 2000.
Probably should move that. This is the car, the actual tradition. This is Roush's 200th victory car. It's another Winn-Dixie car.
Oh, yeah. Right here. This one.
It's in the actual condition.
Actually from
it came off the track. It's actually 1999.
Not 2000.
This is a 2000 body.
That's from 1999.
I think the 200th win was in 1999, so they ran this car at 2000. Okay.
Well, look, it's got all the names
and
races on
it. No, because this is in the condition that it came off the track on, so it's the one that did that.
Okay. Well, here's the Mark Martin Gold car. 03.
500 start car.
Viagra.
Hey, look, it's the company that gave me my COVID vaccine.
Yeah, they're not remembered for this anymore. They're remembered for the vaccine.
This is Ricky Stenhouse.
Hold on, I overlooked the giant Viagra sign.
How can you miss that?
How can you miss that?
I saw Pfizer, but not Viagra. Wait.
This is Stenhouse.
Oh, that's
this
right.
This is his first Xfinity Championship. This is the Black
Ball
Angus.
No, it's his first win.
Might be his first win. It is his first win. Okay. But the 2011 was when he won the Xfinity Series Championship. Here's Mark Martin's Valvoline car. It's from the 90s, like mid-90s, I would say, maybe 95, 96.
Golden era.
Great car.
I know, this is Carl Edwards' Michigan win from June 2007.
Yeah.
This was also on display at MIS in 2018.
Pretty cool.
I still remember when Office Max and Office Depot were two different stores.
I think this was...
This.
I think this is when he finished like third.
Farmers repair
this
their
is
own
Kurt
tractors.
Bush's first?
No, this is Chad Little.
Well, because Kurt Busch ran a couple of these.
Yeah, in 2000, but this is like 98. See, because of the 50th anniversary.
Oh, yeah.
I think what happened was they ran out of Tauruses, so they gave Little the Thunderbird.
Underbird.
So, but I think he ran like fifth in the Daytona 500 that year. This might be the
over the last 35 years, he committed to winning on and off the track. From at Red Sox Stadium.
Oh, this is their first win or first year. It's either their first win or their first year.
Mark Martin car.
This is the Stroh's Light car. So this was 88 or 89.
I think it was 88.
Bush Series champ, Xfinity champion, you know, whatever. This is Greg Biffle's number 60 Granger Industrial Supply Ford.
Got into the Cup Series after this.
Yep. Speaking of.
Uneventful 2003 season.
Well, he won Daytona. Compared to McMurray.
And he missed a race. So.
Compared to McMurray, he was horrible. This is his 06.
05.
05.
05 car right here.
Yeah.
Nope. Maybe this was his Homestead win.
Could be 04. Who knows?
04, 05. It could be his first career.
No, National Guard car.
They don't have his Daytona win.
This was the Japan car.
From Japan? How can you tell it's from Japan?
Kosai.
Oh.
The Japanese flag.
Oh.
They ran a few exhibition races in Japan.
This one over here.
This is Carl's Dish Network car. I think this was his 2007 championship.
Yeah, it's from the Xfinity Series.
And this is Kurt Busch's championship car from 04.
Prize
now, actually, this is a replica.
Yeah, because it wouldn't have confetti on it.
Kurt has the actual car.
Okay.
So.
But does Kurt have his 03 title car then too?
I don't know. I would assume so. But Kurt has his. Kurt actually told a story about it. It's kind of cool. What happened was Roush sold it to an ARCA team, and Kurt bought it back and restored it.
Nice.
So this is a Jeff Burton 2001.
Yeah, is it 01? It looks like more like an 03 body.
01, 02, 03, one of those.
It's definitely 03. All one and 02 had different body looks.
Okay.
A Mustang engine.
It's the Sicko car. Is that a Mustang engine?
Mustang from 1994.
No, it's not. Don't touch it.
I did touch
that's one of the cars.
Here's Kurt Busch's. This is how.
To know how an engine operates, that thing is completely off its driving wheel.
Well, your dad works in a car place, so.
Yeah, this, if you were to try to do this, the engine would not work just because the drive belt is not even on its wheel. So it would either break the drive belt or we're out.
Here's Kurt Busch's X-side truck. So this is how we got to start in NASCAR.
Some banners and posters up here.
Race fan stuff.
Some signs. This is an interesting one. I don't think I've seen this. This is a. I don't know who drove this.
Subway.
Oh, I know what this is. This is the Remember that show heat they did?
Is this?
Yeah.
No, that's not
This is a show.
Remember they? Oh, this is
a
show.
Remember they did like the show. They did like a TV show where they had a bunch of drivers try out. And like I think David Reagan won.
Is that what this is?
Yeah.
This is Who is this?
This is Colin Brown.
Who are your shirts autographed?
Yeah, that's right.
Right, autograph. Nice. This is his first.
This is his truck win.
At Michigan.
This is Biffle's championship-winning truck.
Nice.
From 2000. The Granger car. Oh, and this is Carl Edwards. I think this is like a special edition.
The Mark Martin theme one for sure.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
And then this is a Thunderbird. 87 Thunderbird Turbo Coupe. Oh my god. It's the Justice League cars.
Oh my god, what is that? Oh my god.
The Justice League cars.
They're all diecast.
No.
See, Batman, Superman, Martian Manhunter, Flash, Green Lantern, Wonder Woman.
Oh my god, Justice League collection. Oh, fuck the glare. There's a glare.
There is. Oh my god. I don't know why the Wood Brothers got Wonder Woman.
I don't know why Ricky Rudd got one.
Yeah.
I don't know how that's possible.
I want to know what this is, but there's a tarp under covering it. So.
It looks like kind of like a Ghostbusters car, but not really.
That's a dope car. This is a Mercury Comet. This is a Mercury Comet. And some Mustangs. Oh, this is the Bondurant Driving School.
Orange car.
Mustang.
Therefore my favorite. No, it's not, actually. Hey, put your mask up correctly.
Hey, you see that orange color on the car?
Yeah.
You want to build a shed. You want to build a shed. You want to build a shed.
I don't get it. Over here, we have a random Ford Super Duty.
Look at that. It's got a...
And it's got an Airstream trailer.
And a fan that's not on.
Oh, wait.
See if I can get a good look in it. No, I just see myself. Hi. I think that's a Model TT. And I think this is a Model TT too. Forgot Ford made tractors. This is a go-kart.
Oh my gosh, that looks...
Go-karts.
And it's AmeriCorps. And there's a golf cart.
These would be like a safety hazard for any place to run.
Yep.
Well, they look like they were run back in like the 90s, so
imagine if a high caliber visit number one incident happened with one of those.
You
would have probably tipped over.
I probably would have tipped it over.
That's horrible. Here's a Mustang.
What was the benefit of classifying Hall of Fame?
Yeah. XR7.
Here's some more stuff over here.
I don't know what that is.
The XR4TI chassis.
That's AmeriCorps.
It sounds like we're about to go into the music zone.
No, we still got these.
I know.
What are these though?
Wow. some hoods. To where?
Just like Bristol.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, apparently Jack Roush got that.
Cool.
That's it.
Here we got a cougar, another cougar. Oh, but this is Roush tuned. Interesting. Didn't know they did that. Here's a Mustang 65 Fastback GT. 64 and a half. Oh, this is the first year Mustang. First year of that secretary's car that everyone and their mom knows about.
Oh.
We got a Boss 429 right here. Now this is a tuned one. P51 Mustang. Nice. It's a Roush, obviously. This is a personal one. Wow. Oh, and here's a Cobra. And a truck. Here there's something under there. And there's a Country Squire. I've always loved the Country Squire. I don't know why. It's bad. I love wagons. NMCA Flowmaster Drag Racing. And this is an old race car you would see back in the day. The Great American Race car. This is a Woody. Kind of cool. And we got this. So I'm gonna warn you guys, you're seeing some cool stuff, but you're about to see something that you've probably never seen before. It's the Ford Indigo. Yes, this is a concept car. It's insane. It was built by Carcraft, and it's a concept car. They never made this, but it's insane. This is also a concept car. It's called the Cunningham. Referring to the great racer, to a great race car driver. Now, I don't know what this is. Ford GN34 mid-engine prototype. Oh my. Okay, so this looks like it's the return of the GT, but it was canceled. Here's a GT. It looks like this one was raced. Here's another GT from that era. Same gen, and here's the all-new GT. Insane.
We're doing that.
No, they're blocked. I don't think it's possible. Oh my gosh, this is a clay body.
What is it?
It's clay.
Oh my god.
It's a clay model.
Wow, that's cool.
Looks
like duct tape
in there.
Oh, yeah,
those are boats, I think.
That's like boats. Cool.
Here's some Mustangs. Yeah, looks like it. Mustangs. Oh my god. The tune to Pontiac G6.
Pontiac G5?
Six.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Discord today.
Indian motorcycles. They tuned a Dodge Magnum? That's insane. Here's a Mustang. Mustang proposed 25th anniversary prototype. It's a proposed prototype, so it didn't happen. And then, this is weird.
It's like old pace cars?
Yeah, for it looks like IndyCar. This is really weird.
This one too is also, like all of these.
It's really
weird. This car looks like the pace car that got stolen at Talladega that one year.
Now, I don't know what that is. These are Thunderbirds, I guess, but these are totally different than anything.
This is a pace car as well.
That's an 8500 pace car.
This is the Mustang.
More Mustang.
That's the cool ending thing.
Here's another Mustang.
Apparently the groovy music bot's gonna be ending.
Here's another Mustang. And another Mustang. The boss. Some more Mustang race cars. And this is it's a Fairlane? I wanna say? Here's another Mustang. Okay, check this out. It's a Mustang too. This car was very infamous because it was a Mustang based on the Pinto.
It's called the Mustang Coupe.
Yeah, because it was the second Mustang.
Now they just call it a Mustang.
Yeah, because this was so bad. So, we pretty much covered everything. So I guess that's the end of the vlog. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to like and subscribe.
Are you going to shop or no?
The shop.